like better?
I've got to get this one. Hopefully, this thing won't
happen. Well, there's the bridge. Is it the arch bridge?
That.
Thank you.
go see some other things, and we can always come back.
Alright.
Okay? Okay, let's go.
Okay, I want to catch this one. Watch me on both the
so cool, look. This is the cab of the Metroliner car.
9646.
Just turn it off. This is what the cab for
like the ninth car.
Is it a seat?
That's
nice. Metroliner cab car to be exact. Comfy seat.
I'm on seven. Put that on there like this.
I know where it's sitting. There's seats over.
There's seats over there.
If this train's not in service.
Seats over here, look.
Wish we were in a cab car during the trip down.
Of course the train's not in service.
Where's
the train? Not today. Of course the train is in service.
It's
recorded. Hey, you can't tell me you're
the train.
That's so annoying when he says that.
from the Whipping Realme deal. Yes, it is. I saw the car, really, basically.
We live up in that area.
Yeah, it looks like inside.
Yeah. Now we don't. And we're done, like.
Pretty much, I really know about that. Go ahead.
Sure.
Hold on.
Thank you. Okay.
Yeah.
Should I sign up?
No, thanks.
What kind of tickets?
This train.
Anyone want to
stick? Hey,
order what you want.
She's 10 months, she's kind of hot here.
She's
us. Yeah.
Come on, guys. Yeah. Look at this. How do you look? How do you look? See this? Santa Fe. You guys
don't have to start for hiring, yes? Yeah, this is called the Atchison, Topeka in Santa Fe. This merged in, this railroad's gone now, it turned into history. It merged with the Burlington Northern in 1995. It's gone now. So, there's a lot of memories about that. I was waiting for you.
Now I'm ready.
SEPTA, where'd you get that SEPTA hat? This isn't SEPTA.
This is Amtrak.
No bus.
This is Amtrak.
Give him one.
Where's the hat?
Oh, great.
Hold on, I'm going to get you an Amtrak hat.
Thank you.
videotaped some of these trains. We caught the Morristown area on Easter Bunny and Santa Claus train with this camera.
That's
not a 3CCD camera. It's the ordinary one, I guess. I don't know, because I bought, it's a JVC, it's a mini DVD ultra camcorder standard. That's what it is. Yep. Oh, thanks anyways.
Look at the trains here. The alien.
Thank you.
then saw the wire underneath.
Yeah.
Your plastic ties are nowhere near there. Then just take those plastic ties to your roof, just file them down and glue them back under. If you do that, then the reason I know that is I've got another place where I was careful, even with cages, to file them. And I just recently discovered they were narrow gauge and why something got me trouble. So I took the file and filed it, which took hours of doing that to take it off. But that'll save you trouble. If you're very, very careful and you're real quick, you can solder a wire to the rail without needing the plastic. It's
a little I want to get back into the Honda.
Atlas makes low profile. The problem is low profile wheels, which pay to eat the electric wheels makes. And then you're going to tend to have a lot more drag. Your track work really has to be effective. It's a beautiful track, it looks great. The trouble is problematic.
28, 24 inch range cut. Doesn't want to start the shot. Because they're a design problem.
The lights, you turn it, totally off the line. You can clearly see the lights.
It's beautiful. It is beautiful, but it has no design on the trucks.
I'm more into the 50-60.
Okay, so you're on small speeds and something really deep. You can run 2A2s and no problem at all. You know, they'll run flawlessly. Bachman makes good ones. Otto makes good ones. Who else? Monopar and Lifelight. Monopar and Lifelight used to be the joke. They really come up. They're about, if you're on a scale of 1 to 10, Atlas and Otto are probably 10 most of the time. Lifelight and Monopar will range anywhere between about 8 and 11.
Wow. They have come a long way.
Yeah, huh?
I remember the first layout and stuff like that, it had a lot of model power on it. When I was going, I would buy anything and get my out of the hobby shop. That's when I was in early stages.
Well, both Monopar and Lifelight have improved tremendously. Bachman still tends to make things over scale.
Yeah.
We on your way? I gotta check that engine again.
Hey, watch that camera. I'm gonna go get something to drink. I'll be right back, okay?
Oh, hold it.
Stay here.
I was all out. Hey, room in good. Everybody up.
Video camera right here, the mini DVD Ultimate Camera Recorder, actually. actually. I put it here because I want to see the trains going this way or this way anytime I want. So sorry, I meant to wreck here because I need to put the camera here. I have no tripod actually. What is this kind of engine right here?
This one is what I built.
Huh?
I built this one.
You built that one? Oh, is that a 280?
Oh, Camelback.
Oh,
my favorite.
Wow. Put that on the rail. Nice. That is so cool. Hold on.
Let's see how it looks on this one.
Yeah, why don't we just fire it up and I'll videotape it.
I think your one truck might be off. This one right here.
This one there?
No, the one in the front. There you go, I think you got it.
Let's see if it runs on
this. See the beauty. You said you built that?
Yeah. I used the mechanism from NBC's. Yeah, there it is.
Oh, there it goes.
Alright,
that is pretty cool.
Get a little one.
Very fast, I must say.
It's a repeat the cycle. No, that one's a little fast. It's not one of these scenes.
It goes behind.
This is what it looked like originally.
Okay.
The drawings.
Yeah.
So I used the mechanism that was there, put a decoder in it. So this will run on DCC. And on DC.
Wow.
It's
so cool.
The back burner tender is made of aluminum flesh.
A little bit of water.
Well, if the paint came off, I didn't want white styrene or plastic. The problem with styrene, it tends to want to warp back out again. That'll hold the shape, but brass is solid, but unfortunately, it's the wrong color. So I figured the paint's going to come off, I want it to look like steel.
Yeah, there you go.
But you could have made it either, I could have made it a styrene or a brass.
Most of what Prado and Atlas produce Boston's quality control is different. For a particular engine, you can buy two of them superb. Buy three more and then maybe... So... It's new coming out in the local, so I don't know much about it. Not in the local. Comfortable with putting out automobiles and taking trucks for that scale, it's been superb in its appearance. Very well done. And I think that will probably do a real good job. Wait a minute, I take it back. I do have one after locomotive. I paid about $275 for it. It's got a decoder, sound, bells, whistles, everything you want to do, you can call with DCC or with DC. And it runs superbly. So, yeah, so what they're coming out with seems to be pretty good. I just don't have any of the details. I forgot that I had one before, but I bought one still about it. Yeah, I am too. I don't think you're a bad guy, never will. But he was pretty progressive. We essentially shut down all production.
Watch your fingers. Stand back, guys.
For a long year. Just before the
Everybody
else told him to nuts. He was a little bit of a
pick you up? So, Evelyn? I didn't need to put this in bag.
Another person is the Lewis.
Thank you.
don't know where the mother was gone, or what. But when we came home, all kinds of living room problems, all kinds of problems. Had a layout, cars, and the house. I had no idea what I was talking about. And that's what I said. Now, if you know, it's probably an earthquake.
Thank you.
but it's this far away from it to see, but you can see everything.
Don't worry about it, buddy. You gotta be more careful, okay? Near the four earthquakes. That's what happened. Huh? Okay, I'll take that one. Just hold on here. You want to put it up or you back up? What if you run that one? You better send it. Hold up. That's the one I'm hooking you up, right?
Yeah.
This one here.